Hey y'all, happy, hold on, let me take my tripod off. Happy Monday. I didn't even give y'all a vlog today, y'all. I don't remember what vlogging was like yesterday because I was so busy with Jory's birthday. Ooh. But I just dropped Becca off at the airport. I miss my best friend, y'all. Me and her other best friend are trying to convince her to move up here. So, hopefully she will be coming soon. I had to come up here to America's Best because I don't know what, where my, that's what I meant to get. Y'all, oh my gosh. My glasses case. I think I got a few from that company I worked with. It's not a real good protector. What am I talking about? Yeah, it's not a good, real good protector, but I was using it. So I guess I may have to just go back to use it. I've been wearing my glasses a lot more lately though. But I can't even get this freaking box open. I'm down to my last 2 minutes. Y'all probably gonna see the other camera because I'm hurting my nail. But y'all gonna probably see the other camera. Everybody been complimenting me my glasses. Y'all ain't love me when I first got them. Now all of a sudden everybody love. Oh, this is dripping. Oh my gosh. No, what's going on? What was I thinking? Jesus, y'all, did y'all see all that? But anyway, everybody like, these are the same glasses I've been had, y'all. Everybody keep complimenting me. Oh my gosh, you look so pretty with those glasses. And I'm like, where was all these compliments? When did I get them? I know I got them like last December because it was around Ariel's party. Because I think that was the first time I wore them out, was at Ariel's party. And everybody thought they were just kind of like accessories, like glasses accessories. Y'all, these glasses were filthy. I've been trying to clean up these last few days. I said, let me make my way up here. So as soon as I dropped her off, I didn't go do no workout in the field today. I got two other clients. I had to tell them, like, look, it was my baby's birthday. I don't have no time to be doing nothing. And now I need to recoup because she has another party this weekend because we could not cancel. We had to reschedule. But, yeah. So, but we're going to make it like a Jory's birthday slash back to school because it's literally they start school next week. But what else? I think that's it because my camera's about to cut off, but my glasses look 10 times. I was about to get another pair of glasses, but I'm just going to wait because I'm about to order that camera. And I don't need to just be splurging like nobody's business. The perfume that I got over the weekend, I'm not too in love, so I may have to take it back and just get what I initially came there for. Because everybody keeps saying they don't smell it when I walk by, and I spent $400, so that's not an option. I do smell it on me now when I spray it like a lot, but my other perfumes, I literally have to spray like 2 times and it lasts all day. So for me to have to do the most, it's not a good look. But anyways, y'all, so it just kind of cut off, so I'll see y'all later. Hey guys, okay, so I'm outside the girls' cheer practice, and what do y'all see? Range 12 freaking miles. I got here and it was about like 20 miles and I'm already down to 12. The girls get out of practice, it's 5:56. No, it's 5:46. Jeremy's car is an hour behind, but it's 5:46. They don't get out of practice until 6:30. And typically whenever they're in practice, let me turn y'all around. Typically whenever they're in practice, I sit here in the AC and run my gas the entire time, or I'm outside talking to the other cheer moms and we're out in the blistering heat. It is 95 degrees in hot Atlanta. But I think I finally have a resolution to this, so we're gonna find out now. I have partnered with this company right here, Jisu Life, and this is a handheld professional fan. Not just a regular fan, because I have several little portable fans that I bought over the years for trip vacations, and it kind of feels like wind but not really. Y'all know what I'm talking about. It's not like AC air, but this is the world's number one portable fan brand, and you can find this from Amazon. Amazon is my place to go, so I will have the link to this right in the description box of this video. And I'm just super excited to see like if this is gonna work. Like, I'm super excited. So a few of the specs that I do notice is that it's a 100 speed personal fan. Can y'all see this? Okay, there we go. Make sure y'all can see that. So So it's a 100 speed personal fan, smart LED digital display, 18 watts fast charging input, and 5,000 mAh super long endurance safety switch lock design. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull out this fan like so. This is the main time when I'm actually out in the heat. And now that the girls are in elementary school and I have to go and wait in these super long lines to pick them up, we also would prefer to turn up the car and preserve the gas, or we'll be running down. These BMWs don't hold nothing, child. Okay, let me put y'all down. Okay, so this is what it looks like. The world's number one fan. And then I open it up like so. I see a nice little case, I'm assuming, which is great because I will be putting this in my purse. And they have the charger in the box, and then you have the fan itself. Prayfully, this has a little bit of a charge in it, or we're gonna be screwed trying to figure it out. So now I'm gonna turn off the car completely, no AC, and it's already getting hot as crap. I want to show y'all what the fan looks like. And you have the settings right here where you can add or take away some of the speed. And we're going to go ahead and just get right into it. And it's dead. It's dead. Okay. So, hold on, y'all. Hold on. That's a, is it a USB? Is it a, oh, it's a USB. Okay. So it's a USB plug. So I gotta turn the car back on for a little bit, y'all. Charge okay, y'all. It up. The fan is on. It's on the 11. I'm turning it up. Y'all hear it? Oh, wait. I turned it off. Sorry, y'all. Oh, I don't know if y'all can see how much like it's like blowing. You can kind of tell with like how much is blowing on my hair. Yeah, I mean, you gotta squint like that, you know it's blowing hard. What I will rate this is definitely a 10 out of 10. This is 10 times better than the fan that I have that I typically use. And I just like that you have like multiple settings. Like even down to 36, it's still blowing really, really hard. This is definitely sufficient. And with the length of time that it stays charged, I think that I can definitely sit in my car. By the way, the gas did get down to 3 miles by the time we were done with cheer, and it was out of miles by the time I got home. So Jeremy had to go put some gas in the car. So just life, I'm a fan, literally no pun intended. And I am definitely going to leave all the information, codes, and whatever in the description box. Y'all go and check this out. And I love the design of it. This is so freaking sleek and cute. I really like this. So go and check it out. Okay, y'all, I had to go get the girls because I had to test to see how good this is for real and see if it's able to sustain some kids. So we're gonna test it out.
I've been watching my iPad.
You are definitely watching your iPad.
And everyone's watching the iPad too.
So okay, but we're about to test out this fan. Is it hot outside or is it cold outside?
It's hot.
Are you burning up?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's warm outside.
It's warm?
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Wait, baby, I'm gonna put it on you. Is this better than the pink fan that we got?
I think that one's better.
You like this one?
Yeah.
Why?
It's because it's not hard, but you have to keep pressing and pressing.
Mommy,
maybe you gotta place that into those so we can get some hush. some bags and honey, and we can do it in the house.
Jesus, you're going to poke me in my eye. Lord Jesus.
I do it too. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Where am I at?
Y'all see, look at my shirt, y'all. So, anyway, y'all, go check this out. It's kid approved, it's mom approved, it's family approved. So, yeah. Hey, y'all. So, I was invited to a book cover release party for Miss Mahogany. A lot of y'all know her from the Jackson family videos. But I don't know how much I'm going to be able to vlog behind the scenes, but we're at the location, Del Frisco, so I'll stay tuned. Bluetooth not connecting to my little tripod. We're gonna have to figure that out. But anyways, because it stays connected. But every time I press play on my little tripod thing, it's not playing. But y'all, such a great event. So happy for Mahogany. But I don't know if y'all follow her. If you haven't followed her, go follow her and catch up with her journey. She did an audible book. And yeah, so it was her cover release party. Oh yeah, I'm tired. What's my gas looking like? Okay, I'm gonna make it home because I ain't put no gas in this car this late. What I was about to say, honey, I picked up my bag, my little to-go bag. She packaged my food up and I was still eating on my plate, but I was done with the steak. I knew I was done with the steak, but I still had a few mashed potato bites left and then some asparagus. And she gave me my food. She was like, are you done? I was like, oh yeah, you can package up the steak. When I actually held the bag to leave, I was like, oh wow, this feels real light. Open it up, y'all. She packaged the steak literally. She didn't give me none of the rest of the food off my plate. I was like, oh, this ain't one of them restaurants you play with. You gotta be real specific. She probably like, girl, I didn't know if you, how am I supposed to know you wanted those next few little bites? But anyways, y'all, let me make my way. It was a terrible rainstorm. And they got this new feature on your iPhone where somebody can track you. So it's showing, that my house not armed. But look, it shows like this little check-in. So it tells Babe what time I should be home. And if I don't get home, it's gonna beep me to let me know that it's telling him. And if I'm still not there yet and I see the alert, then I can like exit it out. But if I don't respond to the alert that I get, it's going to automatically send him my entire route from the last time that I unlocked my phone to make sure that I'm safe, and it's gonna show him like my GPS location of where my phone is at or where I'm at. That is crazy. That is crazy. But okay, let me put my GPS on. Make my way on back to the house.
Hey y'all, happy Friday. I was about to say Saturday. Happy Friday. I literally just got back from showing, well, I didn't show a property technically because I viewed the property myself without my client present. Did not go too well. If y'all follow me on Instagram, you already saw what happened with the dang on dog. But then, yeah. And then I went and got updates with the property. I didn't do a closing video. This is my client who's like, she don't care nothing about no social media. She don't want no part. She barely even wanted to be at the closing. I was like, girl, you got to show up at the closing to sign a paper is, or it's not a done deal. So I got a couple of properties with her. One in particular we already closed with is getting renovated. Had to go check on those. And then I'm still out shopping for a few more properties for her. She's investing really, really smart. I've been telling y'all to get on this investing kick. If y'all are not where y'all want to be to buy your dream home or your first home, and you have just a couple of dollars saved up, y'all, I'm telling you, like, you literally should get an investment property, let it build its equity for about a year or two, and then either sell it and get your equity out, or refinance, get your equity out, and then use that to purchase your dream home in a year or two. If you're like, oh my gosh, it's gonna take me so long to try to save up this amount or this amount, and then if I do save up this amount or this amount, it's only gonna be able to afford me this amount of property and this and a third, you don't even have to worry about that. Get you something less than $200,000, depending on what your budget is for investment. You can even invest in a $500,000 house. You can invest in a $700,000 house. Most people are gonna invest in something less than like $200,000, or maybe on the cusp of like $200,000 to $260,000. But yeah, hit me up if you are interested and I'll show you exactly what to do. Finally got my new camera. I have decided, y'all already hear me complaining throughout all of the vlogs how heavy my camera is and how impractical it is for me to be a vlogger with it. I love the quality of this Sony. I'm not taking it back. However, it is a nuisance. Like, it does not, every time I see that camera sitting on my dresser, I'm like, and I gotta go somewhere, I'm like, eh, and I'll be using the excuse like, well, I don't vlog every day anymore, so I'll just pick it up next time, or I'll pick it up next time. Y'all, literally, it is so annoying. It's super heavy. And even though my Canon G7X could not fit in some of my crossbody purses, it was just so, like, vlogger friendly. Like, the lens retracted and came out whenever it was necessary, whereas this lens is just out, and once this bad boy is damaged, it's over with. So I gotta be careful, cautious, sit it down gently, make sure like it's not sliding while I'm driving in a car. Like, it's just a lot. And then, like I said, it's just so noticeable when I go out, and it looks so professional that sometimes people are like, oh, you gotta put your camera away. I never really had that issue with the Canon G7X unless I was literally in a place where it was just supposed to be no filming. But yeah, so I got, dun, da, da, da. Yay! Thumbnail. So I got the DJI Osmo Pocket 3 Creator Combo. I'm super excited, y'all. I'm super freaking excited. So y'all already know I got Babe the 2. I only knew it was a 1 or a 2. And even if I would have known it was a 3, at that time, Jeremy was not even filming. Was he filming? Don't get me to lie. I don't even think he was filming. Yeah, that was Christmas. I remember him saying he wanted to, but I don't think he was even filming that much. So I was like, okay, the second version would be great. Now he didn't see me get this. I was like, why would you get me the 2 and then you get yourself the 3? I'm like, babe, I don't even know. But this probably will get y'all a little bit more content. Yeah, I would rent my car. Girl, I'm not a damn working. So we're out to brunch, y'all.
Oh,
you got the same camera.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah, that's why I said that. I said, y'all love this.
Y'all just ordered mine this week because I was tired of my Sony. I said, that thing too heavy.
So does it look like the, you know how the old GoPro, you can tell.
No, it looked great. Hey, y'all. Happy Saturday. I am on my way home now. I did not vlog nothing I did today. And I know y'all are like, what the world?
Okay, swipe right. Okay, you don't gotta tell me this every time. So I'm vlogging on my new camera for the first time, and that's the reason why y'all didn't get no content, because initially I was gonna bring my Sony, because I'm like, okay, I have not gotten acclimated with this new camera, so don't go out there yet. But I was super anxious because I just really wanted to see what this camera was about. I'm like, how hard is it just to press record? I did stay up a little longer last night watching some video tutorials. So I set my camera up to the right setting. So I'm like, I should be fine. However, I still didn't pull it out. So let me just tell y'all what I did today. So today I went out to Covington again and McDonough's to show two properties. Then after that, which one of them my client loved, I loved it as well. But unfortunately, as soon as I left, I'm texting the agent and I'm like, hey, my client loved it. Like, let me get ready to submit this offer as soon as I get home, because I knew I wasn't going to be home immediately. So I just want to let them know an offer was coming. And they unfortunately let us know that it went under contract last night. And I'm like, some agents are real nice and thorough, and they'll let you know up front, like, hey, by the way, we are negotiating an offer, so blah blah blah, or we went under contract, so if you still want to come, you still want to come. I kind of really like the angling of this camera because you can see so much more. I hope it looks great whenever I edit this, but we'll just find out. But anyways, this particular agent didn't let me know. So, and it'll be different if they were just negotiating, nothing was set in stone. But he said we went under contract, so he should have definitely let me know, and I would have found another house, because I don't go into a properties that already are under contract. We're just not gonna waste our time. But yeah, so now I gotta end up going back out to that side of town, because the first house that we saw, it was mid, it was okay, but I was telling my client, I was like, no, there's much better out here. And the second house we went to was amazing, 10 out of 10. So I always tell my clients, we're not settling, so we're not gonna settle. So I probably have to go back out maybe Monday or Tuesday to tour some more houses. After that, I went to Austell to tour one house, and it was recently renovated in a HOA community, y'all. And when I say that house looked so good, it looks so good. And my client, we went out and looked at some properties last week or the week before, and she was kind of like hell bent on townhomes. And initially I had told her, like, be open-minded. I always tell my clients, be open-minded, be open-minded. And she kind of was like, she really wanted a townhome, she don't want to be worried about grass and all that other stuff. But then I guess she realized, like, after looking at some of the townhomes, like, I could be paying the same price for a single family home, have more space, have this, have that. So she was like, what will it hurt? So we found one that she really liked, and she actually texted me and said, I think we're gonna put the offer in. So kudos to her. And then afterwards, y'all just saw that previous clip. I don't know how much was shown in there, but I went to go have brunch. Well, it wasn't brunch, it was lunch, because there was no breakfast food there. But lunch with the girls. Oh, now I'm in this traffic. But yeah, so I went to go have lunch with the girls. We had to catch up. Ashley's dad, her stepdad, and her stepsister's biological dad, Aisha's uncle, he just passed away last week. So go send your condolences if you follow them, support them. Very, very hard. He was an amazing guy. And Ariel's apartment complex was what was on the news last week that caught on fire. Somebody put a propane, like, put fuel on a propane gas, something like that, with doing something they had no business doing at the apartment complex, and the whole entire complex burst into flames. So yeah, I was like telling my girls, like, I gotta get y'all out. I know we all busy, but we just need to be able to get together. So we went to La Perea, and now I'm on my way home. The girls are getting their hair braided for school. School starts Monday. And yeah, so that's everything, y'all. I'm watching my little true crime, so I'll talk to y'all later. Okay, y'all, so today is Jory's birthday, part two, the day before freaking school. I'm so grateful today, cheer friends and other friends who came out. I don't know how much y'all can see. Okay, y'all. I don't even know where the girls went. Oh, they got Jory right there. Y'all see Jory? Hold on. Let me try to zoom in. Y'all know I'm new to this. Oh, it only zoom in 2 times? Okay. Y'all see Jory? Let me follow my finger. She you right there. Okay, there we go. Okay, there we go. Now it's back turned around. Y'all, all these are twins in the room, so they all passing around the phone talking about. Y'all already know Destiny got an identical twin sister. Angie got a fraternal twin brother. And of course, y'all already know Jeremy's twin. So they all talking about that. Okay, now I'm going to turn it back to me.
Because of skin flesh,
Marla looks
like,
oh. Okay, okay. I think I'm getting the hang of it, but that's enough. Okay, I'm just making.